Yeah, I just feel really grateful. I felt that all week, really. Just felt loads of gratitude about what the players have given us, the staff, the supporters. Yes, I feel immense pride in what we've achieved, but I just feel grateful. The owners for giving me the opportunity in the first place, to Jason, who had a good day himself here yesterday and no longer there, but I feel like it wasn't a sexy appointment for Southampton Football Club, me coming in, and they were brave enough to give me the opportunity, and hopefully we have repaid them with a day that they will remember forever, and it's given me one of the best days of my career for sure. I just feel nothing but gratitude and a lot of love for the people I've worked with all year.
We've spoken a little bit about this week, but there's obviously a lot of celebrations on the pitch at full time, my blood.
Yeah, I didn't go on the balcony, so I don't know. But to watch them from the pitch to celebrate that together will live with me forever. It's as a group of players and young men, they've been incredible what they've done and how much they've grown together in terms of spirit and togetherness. And I thought that would probably be the toughest bit at the start of the season when I saw how much the group had been fractured and not together and all that stuff after relegation. So to watch that, to watch them enjoy that, to watch them show the love they show for each other every day, and to how they've been this week, the feeling they've had and how together they are, have been amazing. And I hope we can keep as many of that group together as we possibly can. I said to them after, this is football and it'll be the last time we're all together as a group, because things change, people move on. So for them to really, really enjoy it, and I hope they do. And I'll probably end up in bed alone tonight, crying my eyes out and feeling nothing but love for them, because I do. And it's such a fine balance. Is when I ask them to do the stuff they're doing on the pitch, it's not easy to show the courage they play with. And when they do it and they make a mistake and they continue to do it, is like incredible. I'll never ever take that for granted. And then the love you feel for them, but the balance of that and being really demanding and brutally honest with them at times is difficult, in the same way it is like with your kids. And I feel sometimes probably the balance is too far one way and too far the other, but I felt like we found a sweet spot in the last few weeks, and I think the players have been, they've been incredible.
We just spoke to Jack Stevens out there, and he was literally in tears as he was trying to explain to us how he felt. I'm sure he's not the only one as well, but so much pride for him about what's happened today, and the journey he's been on, and I suppose it's exactly the same for all of you.
Yeah, I'm glad that we can give... Look, Jack's given himself a moment like that. He knows what I feel about him. He's one of the best human beings I've ever had the pleasure of working with. Cares so deeply, so intense. And as a leader, he's really, really grown this year, and I think he'll continue growing in his role as the captain. And some of the stuff he does on the pitch is amazing. So he's played out of position for us for the last however long, really, and did it with so much energy, intensity, wants to learn all the time. They're a big part of the process, especially the guys at the back when we're trying to build up and what we do, and always ask questions, want to learn. Yanni be the same, Taylor, who becomes our player now, which is really nice. So yeah, I'm so pleased for Jack after last season being away from the club that he loves, which in my opinion is madness, but I wasn't here. But for him to have that day today is beautiful.
Yeah, you mentioned Taylor, your player now. It seems like
Barney
as well.
Taylor, I don't know how much we paid for him, but wherever it was, it'll be worth it for sure. I said to him before the game, I joked with him this morning, I said that the biggest motivation for me today is that we win so you can carry on working with me and you'll be stuck with me. And but I genuinely mean it. It is one of the things I was so desperate to win today, is to continue working with him, because I think he has such a high ceiling. I really believe he'll go and play for his country many, many times. And I hope we can help him on his journey to get there.
Just a couple more quickly, if I can. Just on Brooksy, obviously he's so disappointed.
Yeah, he's dislocated his shoulder, so really gutted for him. I thought he was so good against West Brom, and he wasn't meant to play, so we had an injury the day before, and he came into the team, and I said to him, I feel like things happen for a reason sometimes, and he came in and was honestly his best game for us, and then he started the game really good today, really threatening, and for him to then do that, really disappointed for him, but he's in there loving it and enjoying it, and hopefully... bit of champagne, a few beers will numb the pain a little bit for him as well. So he's been a brilliant addition for us in his personality and the way he plays football. And I thought big Shout to Sam Adozie when he came on. I thought he was outstanding. He was so good. Really top performance from him. And he cramped on the occasion and being young and hot. He had to come back off, but it wasn't about performance. I thought he was really, really top. So this group is there and they support each other. And we always talk about the importance of being ready if you're not playing. And I just feel bad for the guys that didn't get on. And I feel really sick for Sekou having to leave him out this morning. The squad and rest him in that decision for 48 hours really is the worst part of the job, so I felt sick about that. But he's in there celebrating with the guys, and that means a lot. And yeah, it's part and parcel of the job, unfortunately.
Just find the season's now over, so can you tell us any more about the future of Chad and
Stuart Armstrong? Yeah, we'll try and keep all three. I think that's been the plan the whole time. Whether or not we can, I don't know. So I know that there will be offers for all of them, and probably offers that will pay them more than we can. And then hopefully the feeling they have and all that stuff will overweigh financial game. But maybe there'll be other things about it, about location, club, how they feel about it. But we'll do our very best to try and keep all three. I think all three of them have been really outstanding. We've missed you since you've been injured. Shea's been, and the effort Shea put in to get fit today and be on that pitch, I don't think I'll ever take for granted. I feel so grateful to him for doing that. And then Big Al, I guess I'm a bit of an idiot for not playing him a bit sooner, but I think we have such a brilliant goalkeeping department here with Gavin and Joe as well. But I'm so pleased for Al that it finished in this way. It feels like right for him to come in and do that. And as I said, maybe it was meant to happen that he came into the team at some point. And he's been immense since he come in. So we will try and keep Al as well, and we'll keep our fingers crossed. And it's my job now to try and squeeze more money out of Phil and the board and everyone, and see where it takes us. Not for myself, for them, for their contract.
Before the goal, I looked like you were sort of saying just stay patient.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I felt we were just missing a few opportunities to make Leeds run a little bit more and to spend a bit longer in their half, and it was like a bit tension in the game, which you understand because it's a final. So we missed a few passes that we'd never normally miss. So just try and tell them to stick to the game plan a little bit. And then we had one action where it was a brilliant move where Armour went through and tried to square it to Will, and Joe Roden did brilliantly to get back in. And I felt that changed the game a little bit for us and put a little bit more fear into Leeds about pressing so aggressively. And then we scored a really, really nice goal. It's something that the guys work on a lot in terms of the way it built up. And I'm just, yeah, I didn't want us to defend as long as we did in the last 25 minutes, but with the tension in the game, and I understand that it's such a big occasion. But I thought when we had to defend, we defended so well. And Alex, when we needed him, was brilliant.
Justin.
Russ.
Thank you.
It's 9 years, actually, that you climbed those steps.
9 years yesterday, yeah. Yeah, it's different. I don't want to, like, do down the feeling I had at Norwich because I was the captain and been relegated and took that really personally the year before and was so hurt. So then to go and do it as a player was amazing, but it feels, I don't know, it feels really different as a manager with my family feel the weight of that so much more now than they did when I was a player. Because I guess they know my job is at stake at any point with that and the precarious nature of this job. So that adds an extra weight. And then the team is going out onto the pitch in the vision that you want them to be in, and with your instruction and us as a coach and staff, so you feel that as well. So this is probably the best feeling I've ever had. In
quite a journey for you.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm. Swansea now, this, and you know, remarkable that we've been out passing, you know, in terms of the stats, any team in the top five European leagues in terms of possession.
Yeah, yeah, and I know, like, possession doesn't win games and all that stuff, but is a vehicle for us to try and take some randomness out of the games. Football's very random, but it's also a vehicle for us to say to the players, this is the best opportunity you have to show the best version of yourself. I really believe that. So you can show you can run, you can fight, then you can show you can take the ball in any situation. You can give the player next to you exactly what they need on the ball and show them a bit of love and care and detail. And I think for me, if you win this way, it has to be the for me, it's the best way. It doesn't mean it's the right or the wrong way. There's no right or wrong way, but it's what I believe in. It's what we believe in. And we finally won something doing it. So I guess, yeah, it will be some form of validation for some people, but I love what I do and we're not going to change. And now I'm sure it will start. It probably already has, that we won't be able to play this way in the Premier League and all of that stuff and the scrutiny and intensity that are coming up. So it's up to us to prove ourselves right and make sure that we embrace it without losing who we are.
Can I just comment down, once you, I mean, it has to be like for you, pitting your wits against some of the top coaches in the world and obviously mm-hmm. players against the top players.
Yeah, so I pitted my wits against some amazing coaches this season. I think the quality of the Championship's been incredible. Really, really incredible. The fact that Leeds were here today with 90 points, we finished fourth with 87 points, tells you how good the other two were. Kieran and Enzo being linked with every job in the country right now, both of them, I think, shows you the quality of the Championship this season. But yeah, to go up against the best in the world, players, managers, stadiums, is going to be amazing. So I need to stay in the job long enough to enjoy them all.
No, nothing.
I'm just sorry. I'm sorry. There has to be a loser at Wembley. I hate that. And yeah, I genuinely am, because it's Wembley is amazing if you win. And I've been here as a winner and a loser. And yeah, so I'm sorry to them. And congratulations on a brilliant season, because they have had an amazing season.
Hit the back.
Yeah, amazing. Yeah, it's been a couple of tough days, but I think like, I'll always accept losing if we look like the team you want to be and we're trying to be the team you want to be, and that just wasn't, and it was a bit of a surprise, and it was off the back of a tough result against Cardiff, and I think it's my fault. I didn't react well enough to the Cardiff defeat. So, yeah, if it was that, which I felt it was at the time, definitely my fault, and I said that to the players after. And then we all sat down, the staff, the players, everyone, and spoke about the opportunity we would have in 4 weeks' time, which is today, and everything now needs to get geared towards that, and what could stop us achieving what we want to achieve, but what's going to help us get there. And so, yeah, that was Leicester was my fault, and hopefully it was I think it was a big, big night for us in many ways.
Okay, thank you very much.
Well, good. Cheers, gang. See ya.
Thank you.
I'm pissed off. Huddersfield, Watford.
Thank you.